They're working in Anglia. Oh, there we are. 50 years, 1972. Looking around, not many of us were alive in that year. But what a great year it was. Will Shankly was still manager of Liverpool. But 50 years, we do actually have a member of the orchestra who was in Yorkshire then on its very first evening. Jan Jarvis. So Jan, you must have been minus 10 on the orchestra. And this programme really pays homage to our history. It looks to the past, also looks to the future. That piece was in the first ever concert that Worcester Phil ever presented. I think they did the fourth and sixth dance from the set of 16 Philharmonic dances that Dvořák wrote. We just did the first, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth dance from that set. We also looked to the past in the second half. Obviously Elgar being from this area, his pieces have formed a staple of what Worcester Phil played for the past half century. So it only felt right to perform properly the work which put him on the map, really, the Enigma variations. And from there, he was able to go on and write the First Symphony, the Second Symphony, the Cello Concerto, the Violin Concerto, all the works which have been staple of the repertoire for absolutely years. The next piece, though, really looks to the future. Because last year we ran a composition competition to celebrate our 50th anniversary. And we had entries from all over the world. We even had entries from Brazil and China. Lots of people really interested in writing for the orchestra. But the winner is George Owen. And we're delighted to perform his excellent piece, Worcestershire Rhapsody, tonight. And I'd just like to welcome him to the stage. I'm just going to ask him a few questions. So George Owen.
So I saw your advert and I thought, wow, I really want to write this piece. You are asking for something that encapsulates Worcestershire's rich cultural history and also the celebration that the orchestra is having. So I sent you three of my compositions, scores and recordings, as well as a I think it's a 500 word brief about what I wanted to write for you, and thankfully most of that ended up in this piece.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we thought your application was quite good. Which is So, my second question for you is it's very rhapsodic, this piece we're going to hear, very episodic. There's lots of different episodes of, you hear lots of folk dancing and more lyrical passages. Could you just give a brief overline of what these different episodes represent?
So there's four main sections. The opening is trying to depict the geography of Worcestershire. So it's quite a flowing section, and it's trying to evoke the Malvern Hills, the Rivers Avon and Severn, but also it references this very building. I use a technique called organum, which is two lines moving in parallel, which is a technique composers like to use to depict medieval music and to depict this medieval building. The next section looks at the other two composers in the programme. You mentioned Dvořák and the Elgar, and so actually I looked up whether they ever met each other, and they did. Elgar was a professional violinist before he was a composer, and he played under Dvořák's baton in Birmingham, and they played the Sixth Symphony. And the slow movement bears a passing resemblance to one of the Enigma variations. I'm not saying that is the Enigma, but is other. So I've written a fugal section which starts with Dvořák but ends with Elgar.
Brilliant.
The next section then looks at Morris dancing and I take seven different tunes from this region. There's two from Evesham, which is just down the road, there's one in White Lady's Aston, and there's four from Bidford. I understand Bidford's across the border, but I also understand they're not that too strange people, so I thought it was okay to include them. And so I combine them in lots of different ways. And then the final section looks at the orchestra itself and the 50 years, and it's a big celebratory ending. There are 50 repeated notes in the double basses, cellos, timpani, bass trombone, tuba, try and write some instruments. Try and count them, see if I've got it right.
Personally, my favourite bit is this lovely Morris dancing bit we have in the middle. And this is a great bit where you hear two dancers at two different ends of the orchestra in different tempos. So a similar effect would be, you know, when you go Christmas shopping and you hear two Christmas songs in each room, in each shop, Christmas out. It's like that, but Morris dancing. It's a superb moment, George. You've talked about this a little bit, but as well as paying homage to Worcestershire and Worcester region, it does pay homage to the orchestra itself. What are the ways in which it does that?
Yeah, so it's this building that you play in every concert. It's the staples, as you said, of Dvořák and Elgar, and it's, well, some of the members of the orchestra are actually Morris dancers themselves. One of them has even managed to source Morris dancing sticks, which I hope you'll hear halfway through. And I was even told a very I was even told that one of the tunes brings one of the members of the orchestra back to their childhood, so I was really touched by that. And of course you've got the ending, 50 years, 50 repeated notes.
Great, thank you. Well, thanks so much, George, and we're delighted to play these Worcestershire Rhapsody. Thank you.